One of the biggest dilemma for a photographer is actually to choose which camera to bring when you're traveling, not for work. A famous photographer named Chase Jarvis said, "The best camera is the one that you have with you." So technically, any cameras that you bring is good enough. However, another photographer that I really like, Zach Arias, said that the best camera is the one that you left at home. So it's a difficult decision. In this video, I'm going to compare two cameras that I may be bringing for my upcoming honeymoon trip. I'm going to go for my long-awaited honeymoon next month, and this time we are going to travel pretty far. We are going to go to Europe, and this is going to be the first time that me and my wife is going to travel to Europe. So I'm kind of torn in between two choices. First one is my favorite APS-C camera, the Sony A6000, with my favorite APS-C lens, the 18-105 f4G. It's actually my current studio camera, which is the A7R. And the lens that I'm currently using to shoot this video, which is the 24-70 f4 size. So I'm going to do a couple of tests to decide which camera should I bring for my trip. Still on the trip, I will actually take wide shots, natural, landscape or interior. The second thing that I'm going to take are portraits. I'm hoping to be able to take some nice photos for my wife. The third thing that I probably will take are macro shots. Probably food shots or even like maybe some interesting details on the buildings and whatever souvenirs that we bought and so on and so forth. I'm also hoping to take some videos to basically create a summary of the trip itself, and lastly I will try to do some vlog. My first point of consideration is the size. Ideally I would like to bring my trolley bag that I keep on bringing for shooting events, whereby I can actually put two camera bodies and a couple of lenses inside. But of course, it's not practical for this trip. So my wife allows me to bring one camera bag, which is this one here. Last time when I was using Nikon's, I always bring my APS-C camera for my holiday trip. The reason being is like typically APS-C camera is smaller and lighter. So naturally, I assume that the A6000 will be my best choice. Typically, I would actually mount a battery grip on my A7R. When I took out the battery grip, I was actually quite surprised on how small this camera actually is. On a long event kind of situations which I normally shoot, or even like a long studio shoots that I normally shoot, it's really practical to have a battery grip, so I don't actually need to change the battery that often, and it actually helps on the grip itself. If you actually look up one of my previous video, we actually mentioned whereby it actually helps to balance out the camera. I was pretty surprised to see how similar the size is to its brother, which is the A6000, which is an APS-C sensor. This is a full frame sensor, by the way. So the second point of consideration is actually sharpness. I'm hoping to take a lot of landscape shots, and of course when you take landscape shots, you're hoping that the entire frame is sharp. Decided to go to probably the most touristy spot in Singapore, Sentosa. I didn't actually go to Sentosa, but I went to Vivo, whereby I can actually see Sentosa Island from far. In terms of sharpness, both lenses perform equally well. Basically, I tried them on the same f-stop and the same ISO settings. 24-70 has a bit more advantage in terms of wide shots because the f/4 is 24mm, while the 18-105 f/4, if you convert APS-C to full frame, it becomes like 27mm. However, the 24-105 has a bit of advantage in terms of the reach. On 105 is actually quite similar to I think 128. Next thing is close-up shots. The 24-70 seems to have nicer bokeh compared to the 18105. And at the same time, the 2470 can actually take shots closer to the subject compared to 18105. Next comparison is actually ISO performance. In this case, I think again the 2470 with the A7R has a better ISO performance, both of the camera and the lens perform better in a low light kind of environment. If you are sticking to ISO less than 2000, I don't think there are a lot of difference. I think both of them equally good. In terms of the image stabilizations, I do find that the 18105 actually performs better compared to the 2470 Zeiss. It seems to be more stable, and I do believe if I actually walk slower and actually concentrate more and stabilize it in pose, I can actually create a really smooth shots without bringing any tripods or stabilizer. Point of consideration is actually V-Log. Of course, the A7R has an advantage compared to the A6000 because the fact that it actually has an input jack can simply bring this road mic with me, and I can get a better or cleaner audio quality from the footage itself. One thing that I keep reminding myself, if I'm going for a holiday, the focus should be on the capturing of the moments itself, and of course to enjoy the trip. So to have an external recorder, I think it's going to complicate stuff and it's not practical for this trip. So those are the tests. Based on the tests, the A7R is actually my better choice for the trip. To be honest, I still can't really decide which camera should I bring. One last point to consider is actually price. A6000 and the 18105 is actually much cheaper compared to A7R plus 2470. So if I were to damage it, it's less painful to replace. What is your favorite travel camera? Let me know in the comment below. Hope this video is useful. If you want to know what I do with Acrylic All, you can check at this link below. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.